When it comes down to getting XP in Apex Legends, or at least large amounts in this game, it can be a real hard challenge to do. Luckily, in this video, I'm going to be going over how to efficiently farm XP in Apex Legends Season 10. Let's get right into the video. The only last thing I have to really point out is the new Apex Legends Arenas mode. I believe they changed it so now level 1s can play in Arenas. Arenas is the best way to get XP in general, as well as there are things you can do like get kills, time survived, things like that, which you can do very efficiently in Apex Legends Arenas mode. So first, I'll always bring back this chart. This chart never goes out of date. It is really a lifesaver. I also showed it in my previous season video on how to get XP. There's really nothing that has changed, but I wanted to clarify the best way to efficiently farm XP in this game. And one more thing before I break down the chart, some things will work better in arenas and some things will just work better in battle royale. If you're going for kill XP, arenas is definitely going to be the place to do that with all the other kill related XP things. Now, looking at a brief description of the chart, you can also screenshot it and save it. The article will be linked in the description as well. But finally, looking at the chart, winning your match will give you 900 XP. That's the most, but you know, that is rare, especially if you're just starting out. If you finish top 5 though, you will get 300 XP, which isn't bad. Time survived is where you're going to get the most XP. It gives you 3 XP per second survived. What a lot of people will do is just land the middle of the map and hold that ground. Maybe you're with a defensive character, or maybe you're just going to wait out the clock and get your top 5 finish 300 XP and get all the XP you got for time survived. For kills, you will get 50 XP per kills. It's pretty straightforward, but arenas will get you more of that instant action kills. Damage done, you will get 0.25 XP per one damage done. That's not bad if you get really high damage games, so you could always farm someone with a sniper from very far away if you want to do that. If you revive your ally, you'll get 25 XP per revive. So what some people will do is you'll go in with a friend. They will get knocked down by grenades. Usually they'll just throw arc stars right on the ground and then you revive them. And that's what some people will keep doing over and over to generate XP, right? Boosting. What a lot of people will also do is if you respawn your ally, you'll get 200 XP per spawn. Some people will abuse this as well and have a friend jump off the map and then bring them to a respawn beacon. The hard part with this, even with mobile respawn beacons, it gets time consuming with them being all spread over the map. Not to mention, it is somewhat difficult to find a mobile respawn beacon with the spawn rates being very low. Moving on from boosting and going down the chart, if you get the first kill of the day is 500 XP. And no, this is not first kill of the match. This is first kill per 24 hours, right? Whenever the servers do their daily refresh. That basically means you can always just go on once a day and get a kill and then leave. That's basically what that means. If you kill the champion as well, that is 500 XP. That's kind of rare and that's kind of just something that you might run into. Of course, there is no tracker on the champion, so these are one of those random things that might happen. But if it turns out that you come into contact with the champion and eliminate them, that will actually give you some pretty decent XP. Next, if you were a kill leader in the Apex Legends match, even for a second, you'll get 50 XP for that. It doesn't stack up or anything like that. Just being a kill leader inside of a match will give you 50 XP. It's kind of one of those things that should be fixed, but it isn't. Another weird one that is kind of broken, if you are a champion squad going into the match. So if it was you who won the last game, let's say you're solo queuing, or let's say a person on your team was the champion, if you end up being in that squad or are the person making it the champion squad, you and your teammates will receive 500 XP at the end of the game. It is kind of funny how that works. It's pretty broken because if your teammates are just deadbeats and you were the one who got them in the champion squad in the first place, it's all random if you are solo queuing. Now, if you are making it with a pre-made squad, that's something different, which I'll get to in a second. But everyone just gets 500 XP for being in a champion squad. Now, the next thing I'm going to be talking about are some of the things that actually give the most XP inside of Apex Legends. They're kind of a niche though, since some people won't have the requirements to do some of these things, but I highly recommend trying to do this if you are actually trying to rank up to level 500 maybe. So for the first thing, we have playing with friends and playing with friends times two. So if you're playing with one friend, you will get 5% XP bonus to time survived. Basically, how much time you survived, it will have a 5% XP multiplier. As well, if you are playing with two friends, you will get 10% XP bonus time survived, right? So it actually stacks, which is really cool. If you are playing with a pre-made team, you'll actually be getting 15% XP bonus of your time survived. That is pretty cool, and it actually makes you quite a lot of XP in the long run. Now, for the final thing you can do, this is actually really cool. It's kind of a passive XP earner, if you will. You really don't have to do anything other than buy your premium battle pass. If you spend $10 and buy the premium battle pass, buying the premium battle pass will give you access to this really interesting XP perk. Basically, what happens is you will get 10% bonus XP for getting top 5 and win XP. So basically, if you end up making top 5 and you have 300 XP, you will end up getting 330 XP from that, which isn't too bad. I mean, you get a lot of other stuff in the battle pass as well, so it's not the most overpowered thing, but it is a passive XP earner. So you really can't expect too much from this XP bonus perk, but you know, it is a passive, so it'll just be there earning XP on the side. The last thing that a lot of people take for granted is doing your challenges. A lot of people stay away from doing your challenges because they can be pretty dry and boring, but basically what it does is it gives XP so you can level up your battle pass. Whether you have the premium or not, it doesn't really matter, but in turn it will actually give you in-game currency on your battle pass. So that is another way to earn XP as well. So with all that being said, hopefully you enjoyed the video. There are a lot of ways to actually earn XP inside this game. Just playing Apex Legends is the best way, but hopefully you learned something from this video. Stick around if you like more guides like this. Thank you all so much for watching. Have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you guys all in the next video. Bye, guys.